guys. Welcome back to another edition of the Toy Room of Insanity. This is episode 74, and today we are taking a look at the Aquaman versus the Great White Shark playset by Figures Toy Company. Okay? It's an awesome playset. The box is really cool. The figure, the shark, everything about it is really awesome. It's got a very, very cool, great history to it. So this is a box set that comes with a retro reproduction style Mego figure of Aquaman, as you can see down inside, with this shark down here. The shark is more of like a mechanical shark. Now, this was originally made by Mego back in the day, and I'm gonna get to that, but why would Aquaman be cruising around with like a mechanical shark? I don't know, Mego made this originally, so. But let's get into the set itself, get a closer look at it. Yeah, so we got here, it says Aquaman versus the Great White Shark. Great White Shark, cannot speak normally. I don't know what happens in my speech when you're reviews. It says realistic swimming action and opening jaws. Watch the huge jaws open whenever the Great White Shark hits another object. Now, oh, also I forgot to point out, guys, way down there, it's that little baggie down there. That's the oven mitts. That's Aquaman's oven mitts. Those of you who collect Mego and know about Mego, you know what those are. Those are his gloves down there. And why are his gloves not on Aquaman right now? Well, we're going to get to that. There's Aquaman. It's like swimming past the shark, going over him. Kind of a neat thing. But let's go ahead and take another look, closer look at this box. Really cool artwork on the side. Original artwork from Mego. And yeah. Also the same thing on the back. Got the same thing on the back here. Very, very cool. On the back of the box, it shows, we can get in here, it has some information about the shark itself. It says Aquaman versus the Great White Shark. Place a shark in water, watch the huge jaws open whenever the Great White Shark hits another object. Okay, we talked about that already, we know it does it. It says Aquaman can ride the shark by putting his arm around the lower part of the shark's body. Okay, cool. What else? We got a little advertisement over here for Figures Toy Company. It says, what other play sets and vehicles do you want to see next? Now, if you are a Mego collector, that's a dangerous thing to ask for because, you know, maybe they'll do it, maybe they won't. Who knows? It's up to Figures Toy Company if there's a big enough demand. And that's probably what they're fishing for is there a big enough demand to do more Mego play sets? Well, or I can tell you, the Batcave right here, they've already done it, or they're doing it. You know, you've got other vehicles here. But this one right here, the Batman's Wayne Foundation, as I would love to have an original one. I had an opportunity years ago to get one. I didn't do it, but if they did a reproduction of one, I definitely would pick it up. Definitely would be a fool to not pick it up. But anyway, let's move on a little more on this box. There is a bottom to it. Definitely all boxes have a bottom, usually. We have an advertisement again showing off for Figures Toy Company Migos that they've created, you know, re-Migos, or if you want to say resurrected Migos, because they did not resurrect Mego Figures Toy Company. That was done by Dr. Mego, but Figures Toy Company definitely brought back the original figures. They remolded them and all that good stuff and bringing them back and doing stuff like you see here, which is the Aquaman versus the Great White Shark. This is an awesome thing to have. Now, why am I so excited? So this set here was created originally by Mego back in 1978. At the time, Jaws the movie was still very popular. You know, that movie came out in 1975, but 1978, this came out, and, you know, they're just cashing in, you want to say. But, you know, and there's people to this day, and if you go on Mego Museum, it says it there, but there's a lot of still people in the Mego world that talk about, you know, why would Aquaman be scared of a shark? Well, he wouldn't be scared of a shark. Again, Mego was cashing in on the whole craze of Jaws. And again, in this set, you gotta remember, it's a mechanical shark. It's not a regular shark. It does have a little propeller on the back of it, and you'll see in the pictures towards the end of this review. But it's a very, very cool piece to have. If you guys don't know this, and I'm gonna tell you right now, the Beagle collectors do know this. This is a very, very highly collectible piece to have. Not this one. This one's very cool. This is the new one made by Figures Toy Company, but the original one made by Mego. Super hard to get. Even back in the day when it came out, Mego didn't make a whole lot of them. They didn't. And to this day, if you can find one, it is super, super, uber expensive. I mean, uber expensive. Down in my description below, I'm going to put a link to an eBay auction that's currently going, and you can check it out. Hopefully maybe down the road, maybe a year down the road, if that link still works, maybe it'll still show. But they go for thousands of dollars. I mean, it can cost you 10 grand to get not a mint one, not a mint and package one, one that's in bad shape. It can be weathered in bad shape and still got the shark and Aquaman still in there, and it'll still cost you around 10 grand. Maybe more, all depends upon the how well it's looking. But you know, real quick, let's take a look, little quick look at an Aquaman figure. I know it's kind of hard to get inside and see that guy. I'm not going to do a review of the Aquaman figure, but this is him right here. Here is an Aquaman figure. This is a vintage Mego figure. This is not done by Figures Toy Company, but Figures Toy Company totally redid this, completely redid them, remolded them. They probably, what they did is they took original Megos and just made new molds off of them. I'm sure that's what they did. For at least, you know, the head sculpt, stuff like that. And the bodies are pretty much the same. But this is what's inside there. Now, what's inside the box? Why am I talking about what's inside the box with this guy? Now, back in the day, when they were going to come out with this, there was a catalog that was showing an advertisement for this. Again, you can go on the Mego Museum and check this out. They talk about it. And they're showing this Aquaman that had web hands. So, as you can see, my hand here, but there was webbing in between each finger, and that was new. And apparently when this was set was going to be released, the Aquaman in that box was going to have webbed hands. Well, guess what, it didn't come to pass. They didn't do it. And if you go on Mego Museum, here's a picture right in front of you. That picture is a photo of the one and only known webbed handed Aquaman, and they believe that it is the same Aquaman from the catalog that it was shown in, which is really cool. He's got his hand up. You see to the right of that webbed handed Aquaman, there's another a regular Aquaman with a regular hand. As you can see, it's not webbed. But what's cool is this Aquaman that Figures Toy Company put inside this box has the webbed hand. They did an homage to it. It's really cool. And let's try to get in there. Got too much reflection. And maybe you guys can see without him falling around, Aquaman inside his box. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to zoom in. You can see that and what they did. Totally cool, man. It's really neat that they did that. Really, really cool. So, for a collector, again, for Mego, DC, whatever it is, awesome piece to have. And I don't know how well you can see the inside, the old detail. I mean, that's not new artwork. That's the cool classic artwork for back in the day of, 70s. A lot of cool stuff, man. Even the 80s had great artwork on their toys, all depending upon what you collected, right? But let's go ahead and take a look. I don't think there's anything else for us to talk about, is there? You think about it. Talked about the box. Give you guys a history on the Mego, right? 1978 Mego. You know, they made this thing worth tons of money. I don't think so. So I think you guys, you know, go on Figures Toy Company, pick one up if you need it. But let's go ahead and take a look at some photos. Again, these are from Mego Museum, and hats off to them. I own the credit of that. It's their photos. But let's go ahead and take a look at some photos from the Mego Museum at an original, authentic Aquaman versus the Great White Shark. Aquaman versus the Great White Shark playset. Super rare, super uber duper to buy, because no one can afford it unless you have lots of money. Okay, let's check it out. Guys, that's the end of episode 74. Thank you so much again for coming by and watching my videos and comment. I love it. I love this community. I have a great community here, people on here, collector friends, and all different people. Anybody, even if you don't collect and you enjoy watching this, yeah, that's great. I enjoy doing it, and I enjoy all of you guys being a part of it with me. If you want to follow me, you can follow me on different ways. You can do, of course, this is my hub. My hub is on YouTube, on my channel, Count Stankus. That's who I am. You can also find me on Instagram and Twitter and also Facebook. But I definitely do a spawn from YouTube. That's where I am at. So, all right, guys, I really hope you enjoyed this. If you haven't done it, subscribe to me. Check me out. I do videos here and there, everywhere, whenever it is. And that's it for today, folks. Check back again soon for more reviews, and whatever. You never know. So thanks a lot, guys. Have a great day, and do not stop collecting.